Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial. Today we're looking at brush basics, so we're going to look at how to choose and configure brushes in Photoshop. Before we start with the video, let's go to the Design Cuts website and let's have a look at what content we're actually going to be using in this video tutorial. I'm going to use these birds here from one of the freebies. It's a watercolor, floral and birthday party vectors pack. I'm also going to show you some of the picture corners that are in this picture corner vector and brush pack. And we're going to look at some of the brushes that are shipped in this Turbo Textures pack. So let's go back to Photoshop and let's get started with investigating brushes. Typically, the brushes that you will download to use in Photoshop are going to fall into one of two categories. Either they're going to be the kind of brush that you would paint with to get a painted look, or they'll be the kind of brush that is a bit more like a mini picture, and so you'll want one or two of them, not a whole painted stream of them. So I'm going to this image here because I've already downloaded the picture corner brushes, and we're going to use that to add some picture corners to this image. So I'm going to click on the brush tool here and then click up here so that I can see and select my corner brush. So I'm going to use this one here. Now, as I said, I've installed my brushes already. If you haven't installed yours, you'll go to the gear icon and choose Load Brushes. Navigate to where the brushes are stored, click on the brush file, and then load it. If you're prompted to append or replace, you'll probably want to append these new brushes to your current collection. You probably wouldn't want to replace all of them so that you only had the picture corner brushes. You'll probably want a set of brushes that you've been using plus the picture corners. Now, my brush is pretty big and I get a chance of resizing it by just dragging on the slider here. This is not a tool that I typically use because I find it a little bit hard to judge exactly how big I want my brush to be. So I'm just going to click out of the way and I'm going to use the open and close square brackets. Choosing the close square bracket will enlarge the brush and the open one will shrink it. Just find it a little bit easier to position it and just test its size that way. Now, I want this brush to paint down here, so it's pointing in the wrong direction. I'm going now to the brushes panel, so I'll just click on it. It has the tools for configuring this brush. Now, it's a bit hard to see what this brush is going to look like because this is how it would paint. Obviously, it's not a painting brush, it's much more of a stamping brush. So I'm going to increase the spacing for the sole purpose of seeing what the brush looks like so I can make some decisions about how I need to change it. And obviously what I need to do is to rotate it. So there's this rotate tool here. What I'm going to do is just drag on the arrow, the pointy arrow end, until it's pointing in the right direction. And most likely 180 degrees is going to be the right setting for this particular brush. Now, right now, if we have a look in the layers palette, I'm about to paint on top of the photo. That's generally not a good idea. I'm going to add a new layer so that I'm going to paint on a new layer that will allow me to easily remove these corners if I don't like them later on. I have white selected here as my paint color. That's exactly what I want. So I'm just going to position my brush here and I'm actually going over the edge of the photo because I want this kind of effect. And I'm just going to click once to put my brush down. If I don't like it, Control Alt Z, Command Option Z on the Mac, and I can just readjust my brush and try again. Now I want another brush over here in this top corner, so I'm going again to the brushes panel and this time let's select the one we want for the top corner. It's this one here. It has the same problems as the previous one. It's way too big, so I'm going to use my square brackets and it's pointing in the wrong direction. So let's go back to the brushes panel here, select it, and I'm just going to increase the spacing so we can see what we're working with. Let's click and drag on the arrow and just rotate it until it is where we want it to be. And now I'm just going to position it, check its size, and I can use the open and close square brackets or this size slider here and then just paint in my stroke. So these are the kind of brushes, these corner brushes, the kind of brushes that would stamp. Other kinds of brushes might be face brushes that you get, they might be animals, they might be coffee stains, all those sorts of brushes are ones that you're less likely to paint with and more likely to just click to stamp them onto your image. The second kind of brush we're going to look at is the kind of brush that paints. So let's go back to our watercolor birds. There's just a single layer in this image and it's transparent. So we're going to add some layers where we can get some interesting effects. So I'm going to add a layer beneath the bird. So I'm going to hold the Control or Command key on a Mac and click the new layer icon. I'm going to sample a color from the bird. I want this sort of bluey green color here. So it's now my foreground color. To fill this layer with my foreground color, I'll press Alt Backspace Option Delete on the Mac. Now I'm going to add a second layer beneath this and I'm going to fill it with this white, which is the background color. In this case, I'll press Control Delete Command Backspace on the Mac. So I have beneath my birds a blue filled layer and a white filled layer. None of this so far looks very much like it has to do with painting. But you see, the paintbrushes can be used any time that you're using a tool which uses a paintbrush. So obviously the paintbrush tool can be used with brushes that you download, but so too can tools like the eraser. So let's see in this case how we might use the eraser with one of those texture brushes that we downloaded. I'm going to click on the blue layer because what I want to do is to poke holes in this using the eraser so that I can see the white layer below. It's just a different way of using brushes. The setup is exactly the same whether you're erasing or painting. So what I'm going to do is go and get one of the texture brushes that I downloaded. And the one I like here, it's actually got a size of 569. That's what those numbers are. They're the size of the brush, not the number of the brush. But this is a sporadic grain spray. So I'm just going to click on it to select it. Let's have a look at it here. And I'm just going to paint with it so you can see how it's painting. And I'm just drawing with my mouse here, but you could be using a tablet. And you can see that it's not a very inspiring brush right now. It needs to be configured. So let's just undo that and let's go to the brush panel. Now with the brush panel here, we can make settings, of course, related to this brush. So let's go to the brush tip shape and let's increase the spacing. So these brush strokes are a little further apart. That's going to improve our brush. We're also going to shape dynamics because this allows us to configure various things in relation to this brush. And one of them is that we can vary the size. So it's going to paint small and big. But we could say, well, we don't want you to paint really, really small. So let's set a minimum diameter. And so that's going to adjust the size on the fly, but it's never going to get really, really small. With a brush that has a obvious shape to it, so not a circular brush because changing the angle on a circle is not going to have any effect, but on this brush it will. And so what I would do here is increase the angle. So again, you're going to get this brush that's sort of going to rotate as you paint. So that's going to break up this sort of painted line effect that we were getting earlier. You may also want to look at scattering. With scattering, you can set the scatter amount, and that's going to break this up so it no longer paints in a line, but it's a bit more like a splat all over the place. And if I select both axes, I'm going to get a little bit more of a splatter effect. And you can also increase the count. So whereas here, if I paint it, I'm getting a very light effect. If I increase the count, I'm going to get a heavier effect because it's going to paint more intensely than it did previously. So once I'm happy with my brush, I can go ahead and start painting on this layer. This time I'm using an eraser, so I'm going to be poking holes in this layer so that we can see the layer below. And I'm just sitting on the left mouse button and I'm just painting. So far, I haven't even lifted my finger off the left mouse button. So those settings that we configured are giving this brush a totally different appearance as it paints. Now, anytime I take my finger off the left mouse button, I can just go and continue painting. And of course, you could be using a tablet for this. That's quite acceptable. And a lot of these brushes can be configured to be pressure sensitive. So there's some additional settings that you could use if you were using a pressure sensitive tablet. Now, so far, I've just erased through the background. Let's have a look and see how this brush will paint as a paintbrush. So let's go above the birds and let's add a new layer. So I'm going to click here on the new layer icon so it goes above the birds. I want to paint in white, so I'm going to make sure white is my foreground color. And this time I need a brush, so I'm going to click on the paintbrush tool and we've lost all the settings that we had for this brush, so we need to go and reconfigure it. So let's go back to the brushes panel, which I managed to close. Let's just open that up again. And I'm going to make some settings for this. And these are pretty much the same sort of settings as I did previously. It's not highly scientific, it's just giving us the kind of effect that I want to see. But you know what? If I'm going to paint this on as a sort of snow effect, and if I like the effect that I'm sort of creating, which as I paint it looks pretty good to me, I may want to save this so that next time I want to paint a sort of painting effect, I don't have to go through all of this work. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click this little fly out here. I'm going to choose new brush preset, and I'm going to call this snow. So this is my personal snow effect that I've created using some settings that I've made for this brush that I downloaded. And I'm just going to click OK. And so now anytime I want to get back to that brush, I can just open up the brush presets panel, and there's going to be a snow brush in the bottom. And it's not just going to be that initial brush shape, it's going to be that brush shape with all these settings applied to it. Using brush presets is a really good idea when you have the kind of brush created that you may want to use over and over again. So I'm on layer 3, I've got white paint selected. I'm just going to dust over my bird here just to add a little bit of snow in front of the bird. So there are some of the basics of how you download and install brushes in Photoshop, the difference between the types of brushes that you might find, the kind of brushes that could be stamped and those which are better at painting, and a basic introduction to the brush panel, which allows you to configure these brushes to paint the way you want them to paint. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Photoshop techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below, and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.